I wrote the time warp story actually because I had the idea that I wanted to make music to portray a drama or some kind of a story. And I thought that I would look around and read texts and stories and find one, but then I thought, well, you know, I'm going to try my hand. I know the kind of thing I want to do. And so I just set about writing a story. I came across this idea that where one can find himself in a different universe like that. And I thought it was intriguing. And so I wrote the story Time Warp based on that, and then wrote the music to the scenery and drama of Time Warp.
Thank you.
Well, the wish is a way to summarize the really very subtle thing that goes on in one's mind when he wants something, you know. It's and in our story, we have this this wish for a larger life and for something more. And just by having the wish to have it, the desire to have it, I think, is sets the scene for it to actually happen. So the wish to me is a very romantic kind of a stroke, because it's the point at which a person actually, it's where life starts, when you wish something. When our man finally finds himself instantaneously on the new planet, the first thing that he's confronted with is an incredible vista. There's this city that in front of him that he's never seen before, with lights and unusual buildings and scenes that he really doesn't remember too clearly and is not too familiar with. And the song is just sort of a float through this vista. So, terrain. I called it terrain.
Thank you.
when we recorded around midnight, and then I had these four great players there in the quartet with me, I knew we were going to get through with around midnight sooner than originally planned. And so I pulled out this this piece I wrote for string quartet and piano years ago in the mid-70s that that I thought might be a fun thing to try, just to bring up again. Also, I'm going to use Day Dance in my piano solo concerts as well as Round Midnight to have two pieces. Day Dance is a completely different mood than Round Midnight. Round Midnight's kind of dark and moves slow, and Day Dance is very up and sprightly. So I figured we'd throw it in, you know what I mean? We recorded that old feeling to put on the CD box set, the 5-CD box set that's going to be released later on this year. And initially, I remember the piece from having gone back into my old Chet Baker records. Chet was really keen on picking great standard songs to sing and play. And my wife Gail and I are fans of Chet, and we listen to him in the car, you know. And That Old Feeling was one of the tunes that I was reminded of by him. And so I played around with it and found this unusual arrangement of it whereby the bass actually plays most of the melody. And when we started doing it live, it kind of just clicked, and the guys liked to play it. And it was a theme familiar enough so that some people kind of clicked into it. But you can't immediately recognize it when you first hear it, I don't think. It takes a while before the theme clicks. Thank you. Well, New Waltz is actually a composition of mine. It's something that I wrote expressly for the quartet. It's a kind of a sweet waltz. We sometimes de-sweeten it just a bit, but it can be very sweet, and the melody is kind of Chopin-esque, I think. And I really heard it to be played with the sound of Bob Berg playing the soprano saxophone, which he plays beautifully on New Waltz.
Thank you.
Well, Round Midnight was originally intended and will be on the CD box set that's coming out. But I wanted to have a piece to perform in my piano solo concerts where I can find a string quartet occasionally. I had written a couple of pieces for piano and string quartet, and I find the string quartet a great medium and blend with the piano. It's intimate and it's a small group. There's only five of us there, and yet the string quartet has all the range of the string section of an orchestra, from a violin down through to the cello. But then I thought, you know, I would like to write a piece that's actually a jazz piece, but write it in a way that a string quartet playing it makes it sound a little bit like a classical piece, a piece of chamber music, but yet retain the original feel that came from jazz. So I chose Round Midnight as probably one of the all-time best-known jazz standards. It's certainly Thelonious Monk's most well-known song. And tried to put the arrangement together so that the listener might get tricked into thinking that this is going to be some kind of a classical music, and actually then the theme of Round Midnight appears, and we get a little bit funky, and I tried to blend those two things. I hope it, I think it comes off.
Thank you.